Thank you, everybody, for being here today. Good afternoon. Today I'm going to present some work I've been doing with some colleagues at ISI Foundation at the UNICEF about caesarean sections. As you all know, caesarean section is one of the most common surgical procedures in the world, and actually it's raising public health concern, since the use of C-section, of course, it's valuable, it saves lives in most cases, as it's valuable for maternity health, but at the same time, overuse of C-section has not shown benefits and actually can create harm on the other side. For instance, it leads to preterm births and low weight births in babies. And worldwide, in the past years, the frequency of caesarean section has continued to increase. And on the other hand, interventions to reduce the necessary C-sections have shown little success. And this has prompted, for instance, Lancet to have a special issue dedicated to discussing how to reduce the burden of unnecessary C-sections, because the underlying factor that leads the increase of C-section are not really well understood worldwide, and understanding them could improve the efficacy of interventions. Specifically, the overuse of C-section is particularly relevant in some countries, for instance, in Brazil and China. And for both countries, these two countries alone account for about 50% of the unnecessary caesarean sections that are done in the world. And Brazil, in particular, has the 10th highest number of preterm births in the world, which actually it's here just a number, but the connection with the C-section has been demonstrated in a number of health studies. For this reason, for the importance of the topic for a public health perspective, UNICEF launched a campaign, an awareness campaign in 2017 with a name that is a word joke, Quem espera, espera, which means who waits, waits. I mean, that if you have to wait for a baby to be born, you should wait until the very end, right? And the campaign was launched in April 2017 with a series of informative videos trying to raise awareness about the risks connected to C-section and the fact that it is not really necessary, since actually in Brazil, I mean, it's somehow a type of tradition in a sense that has no real clinical motivation in many cases. The UNICEF campaign was launched on different platforms and different media. Medias, traditional, also social medias and advertising boards. We started collaborating at that time with UNICEF during the campaign with a team of our collaborators. I take the chance to acknowledge on this slide these four people at ISI Foundation in Turin and two other colleagues at UNICEF. We tackled the question of how to better understand the underlying motivations of the overuse of C-sections. And to tackle these issues, we turned our attention to an internet forum, a popular, very popular internet forum, which is called Baby Center, which is actually a worldwide platform, which is very popular in Brazil and provides information on a number of different topics related to maternity, conception, pregnancy and parenting. In Brazil, it's very popular. Overall, the app has been downloaded more than 500,000 times. And we focused on analyzing data from this internet forum, specifically comments or threads related to the words C-section or childbirth in general. So this is a classic internet forum where you have threads with the title of the threads, creator of the thread, and then a number of comments of other users. So for the discussion, we collected data about C-section and childbirth with the objective on analyzing the overall volume and temporal evolution of different terms frequencies in the discussion, in the post, published by users along the gestation period, and then understand differences in the evolution of these term frequencies between users who actually underwent C-section and those who actually delivered naturally. The idea was to measure differences in term frequencies, actually to try to identify a moment of choice. So when a user actually takes the decision to book a C-section or not, and then predict such choices based on the term frequencies. Overall, this picture overall shows how the activity of the users over the platform along the gestation period is not uniform. So we can identify the exact delivery date through the use of regular expressions for about 8,000 users, and then align all the activity on the platform along their gestational period. And then we can see that as we get close to the due date, the number of comments and activity of the users increases a lot. And then, of course, it drops down after week 40. There's something else to think about and not writing on the forum. And so actually, not only the activity is not uniform, but the frequency of terms used in the discussion by the users is not uniform along the gestational period. But actually, terms are most frequently used in different period of the pregnancy. So, for instance, we can see on the top left, virar. The terms related to the position of the baby becomes increasingly important towards the end of the pregnancy. The morphological echo sound, which is an important exam, it peaks exactly at the time when the exam actually is usually done, performed about the 20th week. Nasceu, of course, to be born, spikes up at the very end. And then another very important term is plano, which is, the plan of birth is something that in Brazil, in the medical of medical plan of Brazil, women, pregnant women had to take to decide how to conduct their pregnancy. And here we can see that it's important at the beginning until week 20, 25 in the pregnancy. This is a very qualitative picture of the discussion, but actually if we go a bit more quantitative, we can actually measure a distance between all the timelines of all the terms that appear in these discussions that are relevant to maternity and in childbirth using dynamic type warping. And then we can map each single term in a two-dimensional space using multi-dimensional spacing analysis. So basically here we see a distance between similarity of timelines of mentions of different terms, and actually we can clearly see that three different clusters emerge in the whole space. And basically terms that are more often mentioned at the beginning of a pregnancy, terms that are more often mentioned in the middle of the gestational period, and then terms that become important at the very end of the gestational period. That are all grouped in, as I mentioned, in blue, in red, and in green. And then again, we can understand that at the very beginning, there are very generic terms related to the pregnancy that are important. In the middle, in red, the choice of delivery, these terms related to choice become important, and we will see this later. And in green, of course, as I already mentioned, the position of the baby and the weight for the delivery are then important moment. So all I have shown you so far has been measured on all the users of the website, of the forum, for which we had the chance to understand and reconstruct the pregnancy period. But then we turn our attention to differences among users that actually in the end performed the C-sections and those who actually went through a natural delivery. And first of all, what we can see, focusing on this subset of users, about half of which had C-sections, that actually their activity timelines are different. So activity timelines of users who opted for a caesarean sections are shifted a bit earlier in their peak with respect to the normal users. So as another confirmation also that we observe in the forum, that actually the delivery in a caesarean section takes place earlier typically than the due date, usually 40 weeks, but at least 2 or 3 weeks earlier on average. And so also this is reflected in the activity of the users and the number of comments they post. But then if we look at the disaggregated terms, again mentioned by the users in these two categories, we see also that their discussions are different. So those who opted for C-sections talk about different, more frequently about different things than users who didn't. And for instance, in red, the red curves are the C-sections ones. Like fear is more important at the beginning of the pregnancy for those who opted for the C-section. So it might be that this is an important, a key factor in taking this choice. Of course, the term booked, that it refers exactly to the surgical procedure, becomes extremely important for the C-section group towards the end of the pregnancy period. And also, I mean, we can see that there's a group of users who start saying, I would have liked to have a normal delivery, and they're reconsidering their choices after week 25, and this might be an opportunity maybe to have reconsidered their choice, as I mentioned. So the idea was that since we have these two groups of people, we would like to actually try to classify these users depending on the group they belong to, and so try to understand whether from the terms that they are used in the discussion by the users, we can actually predict in the end whether they will opt for a C-section or they will wait until the natural delivery date. And to understand how well we can predict their choice, we make two type of experiments. And basically one experiment uses as a training set, a set that is basically considers the a timeline of activity of users by fixing the end week, so the last week of pregnancy, the 40 week, and then reduces the amount of data moving the start week of training from 5 up to 39. So basically we're considering in the first experiment only the last part of activity of the users towards the end of the pregnancy within is increasingly smaller time window. The second experiment, which is in some sense actually the most obvious, is starts from the very beginning of the pregnancy, let's say week 5, and then we increase the time window from week 5 towards the end, reaching the total number of posts, of comments of users that has posted over the whole pregnancy period. And we can see that actually the accuracy of our classification, which is a naive bias classification, we measure the performance of the classificator, of the classifier with the ROC IUC, is basically, we can see that basically considering the whole timeline, and we can see at the bottom plot, basically starting from week 5 until week 50. So if we go even beyond the delivery date, the best we can do is 0.85, which is pretty good in the end. At the very beginning of the pregnancy, what it emerges is actually the signal is not strong, actually. So we really need to go beyond week 25, 30 to see a large increase in the quality of our classifier. And this is also somehow reflected in the results of the first experiment on the top panel, where you can see that basically removing from week 5 or removing from week 30 until the end doesn't change significantly the performance. I mean, it stays above the 82 more or less. So in general, the very last part of the pregnancy is the important one, but still we can see that at 25, I mean, there is a change in the behavior, which means that at that period actually carries significance and is important for our classifier, that part of the gestational period. And so overall, as a conclusion, I mean, we have shown that from the discussions in internet forums, we can actually understand a lot about attitudes and behaviors related to maternity and parenting, and the user's delivery preference can be actually identified from their textual context and somehow well predicted from the comments in the discussion. These results, in principle, could be used to promote awareness campaign related to the topic, and this is something that we'd like to further discuss with UNICEF and with you who are interested, might be interested in the topic. And then I thank you for your attention, and that's my contacts. Thank you very much.
Mm.